there's anyone here who sees any reason why Gumball and Petty should not be joined in marriage.
Actually, I've got more than one reason. Firstly, I'm 12, and so are you. Secondly, you didn't even propose to me. You're just trying to marry me in the school corridor.
Hey, guys. Happy wedding.
And finally, this is not a wedding ring. It's a bagel.
So, I didn't realize you were coming with Hector.
I didn't realize you liked lizard breath. Gumball, I am a peanut. That's like me saying I like to eat cats. Maybe you should think twice about the things you say.
But I did think twice.
Well, maybe you need to think three times.
If you lose, Lady Penny is mine.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, did you consider Penny's feelings in any of this?
In time, she will learn to love me.
No, I won't.
Penny! Penny!
What?
Can you throw me my sword?
You mean your broom?
Yes! Penny, get her back! You're gonna get hurt!
And I wouldn't have to help if you were losing.
I'm not losing! I'm just catching my breath. Step aside, woman!
Come on, man. His face isn't that fat.
It's just disproportionate compared to his really weedy body.
Yeah, and because it's round, it's kind of full-looking. And the yellow makes you focus on it.
So if it is a little fat, it's not that fat.
It's just very, very plump.
Fat-faced people have feelings too, you know, Gumball.
All right, can we just get this done?
Well, I think that was a good lesson for you. Jealousy's a pretty ugly thing, Gumball.
Yep, I get it.
That's okay. You made it, man.
Get your hands off him, you one dead ectoplasmic, transparent, paranormal, spooky, floating, fringe-flicking freak!
Wow.
Can I have a cake or not?
Sure, pick the one you want.
Look, if you want me to have the blue one so bad, why did you bring two? Just give me the orange one.
Gumball, do something!
I think Gumball's made this situation bad enough. Let me speak to her, girl to girl. Masami, look into your heart! You're not a violent person!
Okay, Gumball, your turn.
Don't worry, we'll pull you out.
Wait, I got a better idea.
Too late.
What the... Penny, promise me we'll never be like that.
There's no risk of that, because you're not going out with each other.
Hey, girl. She's loving it.
Really? She just threw a glass of water at your face.
That's because she knows how hot I am.
Something unstable and dangerous, and we need to fix this right now!
Hey!
What if I don't want to be fixed?
You don't know what you want, Penny.
And you don't know what you're messing with!
How would you know?
He's right, Dad. Everyone in the family has spent their whole lives hiding from themselves.
Penny, you're grounded.
Penny, go up, go up, go up!
You're too heavy!
Aw, man! Marry me.
Oh, Gumball, I can't.
Why?
We're 12 years old.
It's just a matter when it comes to love.
Legally, it kinda does. And I don't think Darwin's over it yet.
No, I'm perfectly fine with it.
It's my chick magnet dance move.
Oh, that works really well with my dance move.
Nice, girl. What's that move called?
The bug spray.
That's right. Remember who you're messing with next time.
Wait a minute. I can take whatever shape I want.
It's my mortal enemy, Rob. Do you think he saw me? Have I ever told you about Rob?
Yeah, once or twice.
And then I saw Rob in the mall and explained to Penny about how, like, Rob's my nemesis.
Yeah, Gumball, that's right now.
Oh. That's okay. We're not there yet.
Wait, he's leaving. I think he's getting a coffee.
Looks like someone wants to stay up all night creating plans to destroy me.
It's Decaf.
Oh. It's a weird new nickname for me, but it's still good to know he's thinking about me.
I don't think that message was for you.
It's obviously just some sort of mistake.
What?
You'll laugh at this. I got a threatening message from you, and Penny here says it isn't for me.
Oh, you got that message. This is awkward. That wasn't for you.
Told you.
I've been here the whole time.
You've got no idea what it's like to feel underappreciated.
I think I do.
All the cool guys have nemesises.
Like who?
That boy wizard who had that creepy ginger dude following him around.
That wasn't his nemesis.
Really? He never helped.
How do we look?
Ah, you're going for the cheerleader effect, right?
Yes.
Sorry, but for boys it's the opposite. We call it the frat guy effect. Makes you look like medieval pillaging creeps.
Aww.
Impossible to live without. But it'd really hurt my eyes to look at you directly.
What about now?
Much better.
Some of us are happy being their true selves and don't feel the need to follow this family's backward rules. I mean, do you realize what it was like to wear that at school? All the kids used to call me Peanut Butthead.
Realize what it's like for us to see you walking around basically naked?
In my defense, that bear is just wearing a t-shirt, the piece of toast is only wearing shoes and gloves, and that dinosaur is wearing nothing at all. Let's be honest, it's pretty hard to know where the line is in terms of public decency in this town.
Penny, your shell is part of your heritage. It comes from your ancestors.
If we follow that logic, the ancestors before those ancestors were primates, and yet I've never seen you guys eating each other's lies.
Ah, message from Penny. I know you'll say the right thing. Aw, then she added a little thumbs up emoji to cheer me on. That was the closest I could find to a hand with missing fingers, just to clarify it was a threat.
Ah! I think the princess could look a bit better than that.
Right, sorry. Oh, sorry, that's not what I was trying to do.
Come on, I look as if I could lick my own forehead.
Sorry, let me just,
Okay, whatever. Just get on with the story, please. Gumball, you can't just keep saying the same thing over and over and expect people to change their minds. Trust me, I've tried that with my parents enough times to grow new muscle on my palm.
Exactly.
So you're sure it's not a problem to babysit my little sister tomorrow?
Penny, please, I'm the most responsible kid I know.
I agree. Usually when something goes wrong, you're the one responsible.
Come on! Oh, hi!
You've been up all night, haven't you? Your eyes look like saggy oysters.
You were following us the whole time?
No. Polly was using the Force to appear to you as a hologram.
Right. I'm sure there's an explanation for that, too.
Of course she was with you!
What happened after that guy woke up and attacked us?